Research is everything. Learn more about the company and the product, if any, before the first interview.
It's okay to reference your resume, but make sure you have additional talking points prepared.
Hey everyone, my name is Manisha and I'm a senior talent partner at Mural.
My name is Meli and I'm a technical talent lead at Mural.
My name is Katie and I'm a talent partner here at Mural. My teammates and I are so excited to share a few tips and tricks with you all today to help you ace your next interview.
Our process will always start with an interview with the talent partner in charge of the role. We will let you know the next steps, so you can know beforehand the amount of interviews and the length of the whole process. We have technical interviews for product engineering, case studies for product designers, and written assignments for sales. Research is everything. Learn more about the company and the product, if any, before the first interview. You can always start with the website. A typical question of a talent partner during the interview is, have you ever heard about the company before? And a positive answer denotes a clear interest from your side in the process. Get to know your interviewer too. Connect with them via LinkedIn before the first interview and learn more about their career path inside the company.
Behavioral-based questions can be hard to answer. If you haven't done your research, I recommend reading the job description and seeing the skills listed. Think of a story or an example from your past experience. I found that using the STAR method helps you stay on track, resulting in clear and concise answers. Situation: describe the story or the experience. Task: share what happened or what was needed. Action: what were the actions that you took to help solve the problem? Result: this is the most important part. You want to make sure that you provide details of what happened after the actions that you took. This acronym is very helpful in answering behavioral-based questions.
Here are a few do's and don'ts for remote interviewing. Do, make sure you're in a quiet place. It can be hard for a conversation to run smoothly if there are loud noises in the background. You will be able to think more clearly and be heard more clearly if you're in a quiet setting. Don't read off your resume entirely when answering questions. It's okay to reference your resume, but make sure you have additional talking points prepared. Do still dress up for the interview as if though it's an in-person interview. You should still treat the interview as a formal, professional meeting. While it can be tempting to stay in your PJs or loungewear all day, you'll feel a lot more confident and prepared if you get dressed up for the interview. Don't forget to test your remote video setup before your interview. You'll want to test both the video and the audio to make sure that things run smoothly. It is very important to ask questions at the end of your interview. A few questions you could ask at the end of your interview could be, what does the rest of the interview process look like from here? When can I expect to hear back from the team? Questions like these show that you're interested in continuing the conversation. Plus, you'll be able to get an honest answer about when you can hear back about a decision and how long the process should take. It's always good to ask if there are any other questions you can answer or any concerns that you can address. Asking this allows you the opportunity to clarify any of your answers or provide further context about your experience.
Thank you for watching our video. And remember, be confident and don't forget to bring a great personality to the interview.
Remember, interviewing is a two-way street. Do your research and ask lots of questions.
Thanks for watching and good luck. Hope to see you around as our next Muralista.